frontal, known as what? Norma frontalis. Second, norma occipitalis. Third, norma lateralis. This is norma verticalis or norma coronalis. Then you have got the one which you can see it from the down view, that is called as norma basalis. Now all these, if you have taken, you have got together roughly 5. Those are norma frontalis, norma verticalis, norma basalis down, and then norma occipitalis, and these two taken as one, known as norma lateralis. Right and left, they have got the same features. Now to take any one of you view and then explaining on that. Now let us will start with taking the water that of the, you can say, norma frontalis. So in the norma frontalis, the outline, it is almost all either the oval or in some skull it is so round, where vertical distance is equivalent to the what? Horizontal. That is what we say as a round face or a oval face or a square face, like that. That is the osteoarchitecture, how that is formed. Now in that, what are the things are present? This is what is said to be as a frontal bone. Frontal bone is the what? It is the bone of a skull which is flat and it is a little bit convex from external to internal. Now this you can say frontal bone, as it runs upwards and backwards, it will be going to join to the water. Two you can say bones. One is the what? Temporal, and another is the parietal, to give the rise to a suture called as frontoparietal and the frontotemporal and the sphenoidal further. So this is what? Now basically this, you can say frontal bone in its embryological way. You have got the what? Two, one right and one left. But when it is fully formed, this suture goes, two bones becomes one and becomes as an only one. Follow it. So this is, now this frontal bone, as it runs downwards, it forms one blunt or a rounded, here you can say margin, which is present just you can say 1.2 mm. Above the what? Superior margin of the orbit, called as supraciliary margin. Now this supraciliary margin, it is much more prominent, well marked, and it can be felt in the what? Male of its medial 2/3, but the medial 1/3. As this supraciliary margin runs towards laterally, it will be becoming fainter and fainter. But this you can say more prominent protrusion, it will be not there in the water that of the female skull. Now this you can say supraciliary margin of its medial 2/3 is become fainter and not well marked, and it is not appreciated in the what? Females. So there will be a what? One year you can say depressed part between the what? Supraciliary margin. Now this supraciliary margin, externally it is called as an eyebrows, where you have got the one depression on the skull. Now that depression is called as a glabella. Now on just below the what? That of the supraciliary margin, there will be a what? One margin, which that margin is said to be as a, what is said to be as the superior margin of the orbit. Now this superior margin of the orbit, it is mainly formed by the frontal bone. Now this you can say superior margin of that of the, you can say, orbit dividing into the what, medial, middle and the lateral. Medial part of this of the orbit has got the what you can say small foraminas. Now those foraminas, one will be there lateral, one will be there medial, one will be there medial and another will be there lateral. Now these are called as foraminas. Now these foraminas are sometimes as a notches, medial notch, lateral notch, medial notch, lateral notch. From these notches or the foraminas, supra trochlear and the supra orbital arteries, nerves passes through. Those are there here. Okay. Then coming to the what, that of the, you can say, medial margin of the orbit is the one which will be formed by the what, that of the nasal bones, lacrimal bones and the nasal lacrimal suture. While you will be going to have a lateral margin is the one which will be formed by that of the, where you can say, zygomatic bone and the what, part of what, that of the frontal bone, they unite to the what, to form frontozygomatic suture. Now this is called the lateral border of the orbit. Now this one is what is said to be as the inferior border of that of the orbit. Inferior border of the orbit is not so much so protruded forward than the what, superior margin of the orbit. Now this border is formed by the what, upper part of that of the, you can say, zygomatic and partially the maxillae and the what, sutures, zygomatico maxillary suture. So this is what said to be as. Now here you have got one small foramina. Now that small foramina is the infraorbital foramina, through which infraorbital artery, infraorbital vein passes through. Then you will be going to have further this orbit, which is there, is also called as the, what is the socket of the eyeball. Now this socket of the eyeball is almost all a pyramidal in shape, which are placed horizontally, one on either side of that of the nasal aperture or the external nares. Now this where you can say socket of the eyeball, which is pyramidal like, it has got the base, it has got the apex. The base of the water, that of the orbit or the socket of the eyeball, is directing forwards and towards laterally. And it is formed by superior margin, lateral margin, medial margin and the inferior margin. Now the apex of which is directing backwards and towards medially, and it is formed by the union of not only the what, roof, floor, but also the two walls, which are said to be as lateral wall and the medial wall, respectively from lateral to medial. So those are, this is the roof, this is the floor, this is the medial wall, this is the lateral wall. Ultimately when they goes behind, they unites. Living and apertures, living and aperture. Now those apertures are said to be as a two. One is a what, round and circular, called as a what, optic canal or optic foramina, through which optic nerve enters into the socket of the eyeball. And then you have got the what, two you can say fissures are there. Now those two fissures, one is the what, supraorbital fissure and another is the infraorbital fissure here. Now these fissures, from that there will be a what, this is the supraorbital fissure, you can see, this is the infraorbital, this is supraorbital, this is the infraorbital fissure. Now these fissures, through this, you can say, nerves are traveling. Those nerves are third cranial nerve called oculomotor, fourth cranial nerve trochlear, fifth cranial nerve, that is nothing but ophthalmic division of the trigeminal nerve only traverse. Then you have got the ophthalmic artery, ophthalmic vein, and then around and about this optic canal, and as well as the what supraorbital fissure, there is a one ring. That ring is called as a annular ring. Annular ring. Through that, some muscles are attached. Now those muscles are 7: levator palpebrae superior and superior obliquus, inferior obliquus, and 4 recti: superior, inferior, lateral, and the medial. Apart from that, this you can say socket of the eyeball is meant for to lodge the eyeball itself, and then orbital fat and the orbital fascia. Orbital fascia is a fascia which is delicate. Fascia attached to this, not only the roof and the even you can say walls, right, medial and the lateral wall, roof and the floor. Okay, so this is, now you have to go to the water, that of the, where you can say in the norma frontalis, there will be a what, external nasal aperture, which is an irregular aperture, which is present on the anterior median plane, just below and medial to the socket of the eyeball. And this you can say external nares is formed by the water, that of the nasal bones above, one on either side, below, one on either side maxilla, and then if this maxilla will be going to run upwards and forms the water nasal process of the water, that of the maxilla bone and the suture, nasomaxillary suture, how this will be going to get formed. And now this external nares, that is the nasal aperture, it is dividing into what, two. One is what is said to be as a right nostril, and another is a left nostril, by means of the nasal septum, which is dermocartilaginoosseous portions. So in this nasal septum, you have got the partially by the what, skin, partially by the what, cartilage, and partially by the what, bone. Okay, so this will be there. The same thing will be there at the anterior part. Now that is what is a dermal and the what, cartilage, and then the bony. As because we are dealing the bony, so you have to consider the bones, only the solid parts or osteology. So nasal bones. Okay. Now this will be the what is said to be as what you will be seeing. This is the anterior nasal aperture. Now posterior nasal aperture, you can see it when you will be viewing the skull from the back. Now next part, it will be there. For this you will be having a suture on either side of that of the external nasal aperture. Now this is what is said to be as external nasal aperture is the sense organ of the water, that of the olfaction to be present in it. Now on either side of this, two where you can say bones are there, one on either side, they are called as a maxillae. And above and lateral to that bone, maxillae, there will be a what, a zygomatic, and there is a more prominent felt by the what, a zygomatic, that is called as a zygomatic eminence. And there will be a what, you can say eminence for the frontal also felt, like manner zygomatic. They are called as a frontal eminence. Then you have got here, this is the nasal bone uniting with the what, frontal, to form as a what, frontonasal suture. Now this frontonasal suture, where it starts, where it is there, now that point is said to be as a root of a nose or nasion. This is, it is one of the craniometric point. Okay, now you will be having, this is what, the zygomatic eminence, just where you can say below to that of the, you can say infraorbital margin, there will be a what, one foramina, Now that foramina is called the infraorbital foramina, through which infraorbital nerve and the artery passes. Then there will be a what one more you can say foramina here on the what zygomatic. Now that is called the zygomaticofacial foramina, through which artery, vein and the nerve traverses. Okay, so this is what. Now you will be going to have this, you can say maxillae, as it runs downwards, forwards and backwards, it will be going to give rise to a what upper jaw, giving rise to a what socket of alveoli of a teeth. This is for incisive, this is for canine, this is for your you can say molar, premolar, and then you have got the molar. Apart from that, this maxillae, as it runs towards medially, it will be going to join to the water that of the other side maxillae to form as intermaxillary suture and one spine. Now this spine is called the anterior nasal spine. Then this is the anterior nasal spine. Okay, here. Now you will be going to have one more. Now that is called as a, what is said to be as a, you can say in the water norma frontalis. Now this is called as a oral cavity. Now oral cavity is meant for the water that of the, you can say placing of that of the sense organ of the taste called as a tongue. Now this oral cavity, it is completely formed above, keeping the water that of the maxillae one on either side and the what palatine bone behind to this you can say maxillae. Then below on either side it is completely guarded by that of the you can say body of the mandible and the what that of the ramus of the mandible. Now you can say body of the mandible is also having from front to back on one side incisiva canina and the what premolar and the molar sockets for the teeth to lodge. Okay, so this is what the oral cavity. So here the tongue and the what muscles of the tongue and the what sublingual gland and that oral mucosal folds, they are there in this. Apart from that, salivary glands, they will be going to make its opening into the what oral cavity by means of parotid duct, submandibular duct and the sublingual ducts. All that they pour the soap formed saliva into the oral cavity to keep that oral cavity all the way throughout your life moist. Okay, by the water stimulation of the secretomotor. Okay, now so this is what is your you can say the thing what you can have. Now you have got the what here. Now that is what is said to be as a one foramina here and another foramina here. Now these are called as a, your you can say mental foramina. Now this mental foramina, through that the mental nerve, mental artery will be going to pass. Mental artery, mental nerve and the mental veins. Okay, mental nerve is a what, that of the branch of inferior alveolar. Inferior alveolar. Now this mandible body will be going to join in the center to form as symphysis menti like that of the pubic symphysis. Following, this is the symphysis menti. The lower part of that of the symphysis menti is called as menton. Lower part of the symphysis menti is called as menton. So this is a menton. Root of a nose is a nasion. Nasion is formed by the union of frontal bone uniting with the nasal to form as frontonasal suture. There are two nasal bone, one right, one left. and it forms the what? Internasal suture. Okay, this combination is called as a root of nose or nasion.